Okay, I just sprayed my cucumbers. I sprayed all of the dirt, tried to get a good spray on it. And the cukes, because look what is happening to these little guys. Let me see if I can get a little closer. Look! Something's eating them. So I got neem oil from these. And then... oh, hello, bunnies. Carrots. Sprayed the carrots. Mind you, it doesn't look like they've got a problem. My lettuce. Sprayed that. Sprayed my roses. Because they were full of aphids. My beans, I got right in there. All these little flies flying around, I don't know what they are. Give them a good spray. And I'm in the middle of spraying these ones. I'm just giving a earth under there. Let's see if I can get in there. Ah! Get clear. So I'm doing this all on the ground. And all over. And I don't mind the neem being on everything because it's safe for the bees. Whereas the diatomaceous earth is, no, not really safe for the bees, so. Let's go over to the other part of the garden. And my broccolis. There's a lot of them that survived. I'm really proud of them. I really like the sprayer. Watch this. I'm going to spray the ground. All the way. I'll spray all of it as much as I can. Not too much, I don't want to. And over here, this is where my squash were. And I ended up putting in more seeds about a week ago or so, and they're coming up. Because all the squash that I had is dead and gone. My zucchini's doing really good. And the watermelon over there seems to have died out. I only have two plants left. It looks like something's eating those too. Do a close up in a minute. So my zucchinis. Oh my goodness, I see that. Look, there's a lot of buds. There's a lot of flowers. So there's an earwig falling away. I'm happy with these. Look at all the buds. And that little one over there is surviving. Spraying these down too. Okay, I've got one. This one's gone. See, I really think that was a cutworm too. That one's still there. And that one's still there. Oh, a little one right there, that's it. The rest are weeds, I got a weed in here. Okay, here's the new garden beds. This one, I don't know what's in it as far as bugs go, because I just planted this weekend with all my peppers. My red peppers. There's bellboys, summer red, and what's the other one? Orange sun. So this row here and those two are orange sun. And they survived. And then there's about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 rows of three. So there's 15 of the different varieties of the red peppers. 15 of each of them. seem to have lost a couple. These ones are all here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And on this side. Sorry, I had that on Zoom. Just shows blurry when I have it on close up. This one looks like it's fallen over. And that one's missing. There was one there, it's gone. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. There's another one that's missing from there. So there's a couple missing. Over here, as I have the camera going, tried to transplant some lettuce because it was getting thick, so I took some and planted it beside them in the rows, see if they'll survive. Looks like a couple of them survived. They came up, they look dead the next day, but we've had a lot of rain over the past couple of days. There's my spinach down there. This is where I found the cutworms, literally. I didn't really know what they were, I just thought they were little caterpillars that were dormant because it was all rolled up. Actually, I think I was digging in the lettuce when I found it. And I've pulled out, I'm going to show you here. Let me show you what they do. See this bean plant? Do you see that? When I pull it out, sometimes this is slimy here. I pull it out. There's a lot of ants in there. Look at this. That's what happened about, 20 or so. And there's another one. It's affected. And those cutworms, and I just threw them out here. They're on the ground. They all look the same. Look at this. My string beans. I've been pulling them out as I find them. There's another affected one there. Let's see which ones survive after spraying. I put diatomaceous earth in here a couple times over the past couple days. This one here, I'm not sure that. Kind of looks infected too. We'll have to see as they grow. I'm going to spray all this. These two beds. And my peas that are over there. Peas and horseradish we have over here. I'm going to give it a little spray too. This is our garden in the shade. Cut some of the tree branches to leave a little more sun in the morning. We got horseradish over there growing. And I got peas. Peas look good. 5 rows. Alrighty. Oops, sorry. Had it on close up again, yes. So this is peas and horseradish over there. Whole beans. Cut up the steaks today. Because they've got their little tentacles going and they want to start climbing. I'll have to adjust this camera each time. Look at their little tentacles. So eventually they're going to grab on and grow. These ones here are the green beans. These are yellow beans. Planted just as much seeds, and these ones I didn't get as many plants, so I will plant some more beans, bean seeds in here. See how they do. Okay, I'm gonna have to check my calendar, but was it a week and a half ago? I decided my tomatoes were just too tiny. Let me see. Tomatoes were too tiny. Even after I transplanted them, it just didn't seem like they were growing at all. And decided to leave the lights on 24/7. And they just exploded. So, if anybody says, well, can I put lights on 24/7? To help the growth of my tomato plants? Then I say yes. And the research that I did said yes, that it was good for them, gives them energy. And, you know, I can put something like this in the ground now. Whereas before, I couldn't even think about putting them in the ground. They were just too tiny. My pepper plants didn't grow any taller either. These are about 6-7 inches tall. Yeah. Nice size. I was going to buy them in the grocery store, buy the plants already because mine were too small. And when I left the lights on 24/7, it ended up that my plants caught up faster than the ones that I saw in the garden center. So, it's June 12th, and these will probably go in the weekend. I don't want to put them in right now anyways because I don't know what's in the soil in my garden. I don't want them just dying. There are a few little ones, and I took them all, and I put them in the center so that they get more light, but they seem to be growing a little bit stronger, but they are a little smaller than the other ones. Only about 4 or 5 of them. And